Well, you know, alright. Welcome everyone to another hockey series thing. Now today we are reacting. Well, I'll be watching the Hlinka Gretzky Cup finals, Canada versus Sweden. That's pretty much it's a rematch of, like, I believe their last, like, pre semifinals match or whatever you want to call it. The game's pretty much where it all goes down to winning or losing. I don't know what you call those. Qualification matches, maybe? Anyways. So today, that's what we'll be doing. We're watching that. It's gonna be pretty fun. I'm just logging into my Twitch so I can see the chat. And yeah, let's get it started by analyzing what's been going on. Analyze the matchup here. So, as you see on the screen, the season record for Canada is 4 wins, 0 losses, and 0 overtime losses. And then for Sweden, it's 3 wins, 1 loss, and 0 overtime wins, and that loss is literally to Canada. So both obviously have 4 games played. Goals for is like 30 for Canada because Canada's been lighting it up, and then Sweden has scored 39. Canada has 2 goals against, 1 from Finland and then 1 from Slovakia. Yeah, that too, and then goals differential, which ends up being 28-9 for Sweden. Alrighty, their previous games. Sweden lost won their game against Czechia, 6-2, and then Canada to make it. Both these teams won their game to make it here. So 4-1 win at against Finland, and then the game before that, it was the one that decided what position they'll be in. So for Canada, they won against Sweden, which made them end up playing against Czechia, and then yeah, same thing as you see, that's literally the same matchup here, and then. And then the last, and then like August 2nd, they got a 9-1 win against Slovakia, and then Sweden had a 9-3 win against Switzerland. Switzerland. Yeah, that's just advertisements there. Alrighty. Anything else that they show here? I'm unable to click anything here, so. Oh! Well, that's just roster. Oh, let's see the player stats. So far in this standing, the player that has the most points is Denberg with 9 points, and then he goes to Richie with 9. Well, I mean, they're tied. It's gonna make up for a good matchup here. And then it goes down to Jaeger with 8. Gauthier with 6, and then Benson with 6. For goals, Gauthier have 5, he's tied up with Stenberg with 5. Jaeger has 4, and then Switzerland's Brayall has 4, and then Richie has 3. Assists, Richie has 6 assists. Allen has 5, Purcell has 5. I'm not even gonna pronounce that name because I don't even know how to pronounce it. Has 5, and then he's tied up with, like, all these people are tied up for second. Lindstein has 5. Goaltender average. Slovakia's goalie Slavic has 0. Radulov had a 0 last time. But then last night's game was like Finland was like freak you in the last 15 seconds and scored on him, so he has a 0.33. And then Bjarnason, it's Canada's other goalie, has a 1. Finland's Vinny, the 1.75, and then Czech, he has the ball, has 2. Save percentage, Slavic has a 1. Bratislav has a 0.983. Bjarnason has a 9.50. Olofsson has a 0.930. And then Vinny has a 9.27. And yeah, that's all for that stuff. Yeah. See if I'm able to go back to the main screen I was at. That's the other game. What happens if I click the? Please bring me back. Oh shit, I have a task to sign. Guys, I'll be right back. That means, basically.
SpongeBob, this flapping robot Crasis is making the Krusty Krab.
What the fuck?
But he means no more Krusty Krab. No more Krusty Krab. No more Fry cooking for you.
What is this voice?
Yeah!
Holy fuck!
Oh yeah! Oh my fucking god! Oh my god! So now I can do PS4 streams again. I mean, somewhat of a downgrade from the PS5 streams, but whatever. Bruh! Oh shit, that was clutch! 43 out of 42, what the fuck? It's happening! It's happening! It's happening! It's happening! Yes! 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 Holy shit, I made it! I was being so cocky there, and I made it. Let's go, baby! First! Let's go! Let's go! Yeah, we're playing football, guys. Oh my god! Oh my god! I crossed the field! Goals! My god. Christian Tvorak, he scores. What the heck?
Yes! Woo! 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 Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
Under the sea, don't touch me! Go, go, go! Tap on the dick, I'm gonna die!
The fact you're alive is astonishing.
Go, go, go! Tap on the dick, fuzzy! I'm gonna die! Holy sh! The thing is right there! Oh my f***ing god!
Are you here? Oh my god. Yes! Yes! What? What? Bullshit! Fucking bullshit! That is so bullshit. The fucking thing glitched. I didn't fucking. That is fuck.
Oh, you son of a bitch! Oh, you son of a bitch! Oh no! Oh no! Oh boy, that was the washrooms of death. Get me out of here. Holy shit, how did I manage to strike that?
Ted is the man, so he'll for sure come back. I have no doubts about it. Ted's gonna go up to them and be like,
they're gonna be like, give me the food. I want all the food right now, and give me all everything that you have, including the weapons. I want a new map, I need an axe, and everything in the med kit. That's all I want, that's all I ever wanted.
Yep, that's what I want to do.
Who'd you rate it?
Very. This is my rating. Yeah. Yes, that was very cold. I'm gonna give it a 6 out of 10. The missing 4 because it's not that sweet. Like it's lemonade. Come on.
What the fuck? I need a hero. Fuck off, you cunt. Go! Let me in! Wi-Fi! Wi-Fi! Go! Let me in! Let me in, Wi-Fi! I swear to fucking god.
How was that? Next up is this.
Oh, what is this? No way!
Let's go!
Let's go!
Let's go! Let's go! Woohoo!
No. No, 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 no! They didn't fuck it up. They didn't mess it up. They did not mess up the memes. They did not mess up the memes. Oh, oh. I'm done.
Or I could have been mistaken. Oh, I'm just... Holy shit! Get out! Get out! Get out! Oh shit, we're going down!
Go, Dave! This is content!
Content! Fly into...
How you boys feeling? Feeling like death, yeah?
Okay, oh, 10 yeah. seconds in.
Well, I'm dead in the inside, so it doesn't really matter. Oh my god, what a
What the hell?
Oh!
Jeremy, psycho!
Oh, he's drinking!
Jeremy, psycho, wasn't he, Nathan?
Oh, those kids, ruthless. Absolute savages, man.
Crazy, isn't it?
Crazy, with a kick.
Yeah.
You know what?
NANI!
Oh, give me another shot.
Yeah. No way!
Gone on
you
when you're big around.
Nathan,
you know what? Give me another. No.
Yes. No way.
No, you're not going to screen this, John.
No, I need to
call my feet.
Oh, yeah. Final.
Holy fuck, these are unbindable. Alrighty. And it is... Nom. I get fucked.
Alrighty. I've done some more investigation for you. Looks like the ghost's name is David Smith. It's David! David's the ghost! Oh, that's a room! It's Santa Claus! It's Santa Claus! It's Santa Man! It's Santa Man! It's actually Santa! What the f-
oh.
What the f-
oh.
What the f-
oh.
Get your ass in the van! Get your ass in the van!
Okay, so now it's a...
We're almost there.
There's a safe room up ahead.
Come on, get your asses in here, Alice.
Get your asses in here.
Sorry, I can't go any faster.
Fucking go. Tap out
loud. There we go. Leaving me
twice in one fucking day. Luigi said, let's go. That was perfectly timed. Yes! Woohoo! That was pathetic wins, but ding 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 ding! Amen! Alrighty, today in Bible Boys channel, in the Bible Boys universe. We got some donations to talk about. Amen. Bruh, that's not what I wanted. Where's that Bible boy? Amen, amen, amen.
Uh-huh, I figured you out. No! Close. Come on. No. You don't got the name. No. I've seen you play Fortnite. You don't got the name. Come on.
Now, do it. Now. Go, do it. Go, skip.
Hey, you're good.
I skipped it. No.
You go back a little bit.
I need to be educated.
Wait, who the heck is this character?
You gotta go back 10 minutes.
That was the
before the tits.
Wait, there's a kid.
You gotta go to the 47 minutes about. Oh, that was hilarious. You go right to like the.
Oh!
Oh god, let's see. So part two is SpongeBob. Oh no, what's part three?
Come on! You totally think that is my voice!
What the hell voice is that? It sounds familiar, but I don't know what that is. I don't know. Does anyone know that voice? Like, what it's from? Yo, let's see part four. Maybe it'll give us a clue.
By the way, Loki is my favorite
in No, you're not allowed to say that. I swear to God, you can trash talk anything about me, TelJ. You can, like, trash talk my appearance. You can trash talk my personality. You can trash talk my friends. Yeah, you can trash talk whatever. But the second.
What are you doing? Come on! What the fuck are you doing? Are you bloody fuck? Really?
What the fuck? That's it.
Are you fucking serious?
Say hello to my little friend!
Wait till you see the. No.
Come on. No! Oh, never got it. They just left. Bruh. Phew.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another. All guys, episode, let's go. In today's Fall Guys episode, I guess, I'll be playing Fall Guys until I actually win a match. So, depending on how I do, this stream could very well go until the end of time. Ah, nice. Perfecto.
What?
Bruh.
Yes! Oh boy, we're done zone. We're done zone. Second ring here. Third, at least. I'll know that for next time. Vas-y, mon ami! Go! Go! Woo! No! We're fucked.
Bruh.
Fucked. Come on, get the fuck out of my way, buds. I thought I was gonna get blocked. No! Oh no! Fuck you! No! No!
Yes!
Yes! Yes! Yes! Let's go! Me. Fuck off!
You're fucking back!
No! You fuckers better hold me back. Ooh, mother gone. We made it. Motherfucker!
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine. You're
We're done.
Really fine,
We're done. I looked at it from the wrong direction. Move! Yes! Oh, fucking hell! My luck. No! Fuck off, pineapples. It's gonna happen. It's not gonna happen. We are super lucky if it happens. For a miracle! Come on! Hold it. Get up, double neck! Oh, motherfucker! Hi, get fucked. No! Fuck you! No! Or my family ever again. We're dead. Let's go! And jump in that and your golden bun. Fucking go! Oh no, never mind. Buddy's gonna get it. I was gonna say. I get fucked, Ben. Ah! No! Yes! No! Yes! No! What the fuck are you doing? Let's go. No! Let's go. Come on, just give me one. We're making it, boys. We're safe. Oh shit, this is my time to redeem myself. We're doing this right fucking now. the fuck? Oh boy, we're fucked majorly. We're fucked hard. Yes! Woohoo! Ole, 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 ole. Alrighty, thank y'all for watching. And yeah, as always. Stay safe, wear a helmet, and I'll see y'all later. Bye bye.
It's the guy.
Otherwise, you're gonna know, like something.
Hi guys, I've never been on television. Hi, my name is David. You know, on Tinder.
Yo, what is up, guys? I am back from the delivery. Sorry for that whole wait. So, the score right now is 2-1. Canada, holy shit.
Did you have fun?
Alrighty. I'm gonna see what I can put in terms of, like, statistics and shit on there.
Check this out. It's nice, right?
Alrighty. Whoa, 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 whoa. There you go. Well, I connect to the Wi-Fi phone, you goof. Alrighty, so let's see what's been going on while I was gone. Let's see who scored those goals. Bum ba dum bum ba dum bum ba dum ba. Come on, load up, bruh. Did I fuck it up? I think I broke my thing. Bonjour, anyone there? Yellow. Fuck you, don't tell me the Wi-Fi is being poop again. Okay, so at least tell me who scored the goal.
Olin Dyke from McBride, BC, just outside Prince George. Waiting for us, Hugo Pedersen.
Alrighty. Game summary. Hlinka Gretzky
picks up the loose puck and feeds it across for Height.
Yeah, it's literally just the fucking thing being like.
Height back with it. Drops that back to Bonk, skips away from him, a foot race for it now as Bonk hustles back and knocked that away from Willie Johansson. Two Canadians converge there and slam in.
All right, so it's how. It's how he is comfortable playing on the is how T Tanner Howe scored the first goal, and then Pedersen replied with a goal, and then Ethan Gauthier scored for Canada, and it was assisted by Allen. And then the first goal was assisted by Barlow, and then the second, and then the first goal for Sweden was assisted by Nilsson.
Oliver has looked totally comfortable.
You know what? I'll just grab those things since the website's currently dying. I think it's like everyone's like, oh, what's going on?
Even more impressed with Oliver Bonk's game as it continues to improve.
Oh, never mind.
He develops in other areas.
It's alive.
Gauthier slides that back to Allen. Cameron Allen with a rolling puck. Moves that by Stenberg.
Oh boy, what did I do?
By Jaeger. Jaeger to Gauthier. Gauthier trying to shovel that back in front, intercepted by Nord.
Bonjour, anyone?
Benson who flips it across to Allen. Cameron Allen fires it back in, waiting for it there is Nord. Plays for Brynäs in the Swedish Junior League. That centering pass goes wide. Brynäs Javla, just north of Stockholm.
Fuck.
Allen with it. And here comes Allen. Captain Gain center ice as Canada's changing. Allen comes dashing in, drops that back in the slot, picked off by Stenberg. And now Calaport plays it back in as Canada completes the change. Inside.
Alrighty, I guess I'm changing.
Crystal knocks it down. Andrew Crystal back across to Rakoff, where Sid shovels it back in front. And Calaport had that shot blocked on a good defensive play by.
It's like every single time I go, like, okay, Rakoff, I say something, it's like, no. Give me another chance. Spins back in front. Okay, that's the wrong thing.
Molendijk back with it. One-handed is sticky, holds off Nilsson. Now Molendijk back with it.
Hello? Anyone there?
Lead pass for Felix Nilsson, but the play is offside at the Canadian line. Carson Rakoff, I mean, he's big. He can.
Alrighty, I'm removing this thing here.
I mean, imagine you're getting hunted.
And then using this.
You know he can catch you, and when he does catch you, he finishes you physically. Hard driving play. I know he plays in the middle. Might end up being a winger as he advances into pro hockey, but those qualities of skating and power and physical competitiveness are always valued. Had a hat trick for Kitchener last year. The third youngest Kitchener Ranger ever to record a hat trick behind Mike Richards and Jeff Skinner.
This one's like always alive. But I think perfecto already.
Denver Barkey brings it out. Slides that by Lindstein. In comes Barkey. Centers it. Just missing. That was Barlow. Price plays it back in.
Nothing that great, but at least it's something. There's not as many tracking stuff, I guess, on the ice as there is.
Barlow. Up ahead to Barkey. Barkey winds his way in, tied up by Bergstrom. Puck still loses. Barkey tries to knock that Brady. Stays on the hunt for the puck.
Alrighty.
As Nord brings it out, the top line on the ice for Sweden. Nord. For Stenberg,
yes, we're in the summer hockey. The best of the best times. Alrighty. Hockey time.
Price chips it ahead, dying seconds now the period. Lynn moves in.
And rest in peace. The freaking. So yeah, I had a delivery to do. If you weren't, I don't know if you were watching, but I had a delivery to do, and I ended up missing a good chunk of like through the first period. Canada outshoots Sweden 12-9 here in the first period.
Tanner Howe and Ethan Gauthier have the goals for Canada. A 2-1 lead after two periods of one period of play, rather. Our first intermission is coming up.
Yeah.
2022.
Alrighty. Hlinka Gretzky Cup. And there goes my freaking camera. Voila. Okay. Well, you didn't miss much. Alrighty. Intermission time. Pretty much recap the game there, so.
I mean, I'm going in my ninth year next year and I haven't won so.
So this is basically like the weird NHL stuff is what I've been doing during the season. This is the last one I can do, so I'll have to figure out what to do during the intermission. Fix that up real quick. iPhone, stay up. I need you to like be invisible. I need to see you just in case I get another order. Alrighty, let's try this here. Display capture. Oh boy. Alrighty, let's see. Okay, we're back. Tournament lead, but in comes Ethan Gauthier, who had his sixth here in the first period. Alrighty. But we're all tied up in the second. Boom. Arturi Alasura. Boom. Voila, smooth transitions. Lead, and they wouldn't look back from there. Late in the third, the Czechs looking for the equalizer. Shallow with some room. But a nice yeah, there's a bit of a delay. Because of that freaking glitchy internet. Speaking of the Finns, since 2012, that ends an 8 tournament drought. Fifth medal overall, so we've got a gold at the Olympics for Finland, a gold at the men's, well, then,
ranked number 1 in the
gold
world,
and
now a bronze at the Hlinka Gretzky Cup, and oh yeah, a bronze from the spring.
They have
at the U18 world,
Finns just won bronze, and
that being Czechia. And we mentioned Aaron Kivihara.
The last time they went for gold was against Canada. And they lost. Haha. Get fucked.
Birthdays as well, but he has been standing out all tournament long. What sets him apart from the rest?
Oh, the way he thinks the game, Laura. He's.
Alrighty. So yeah, next intermission. I guess we still have like a good chunk of them of that video left. So we'll do that, unless I somehow end up needing to do a delivery. Sorry, I'm just looking at Snapchat. Alrighty. I thought the reason why I'm checking my phone is because I thought there was a someone messaged me, so I had to check and reply. Alrighty. I may have overestimated. They're still playing replays from the game that just happened. Well, Rising Psycho, has your favorite character changed since? Oh. More messages? Nice. Alrighty, what the heck? I thought we were gonna get some hockey. Some second period action hockey here. Apparently I was wrong. But, oh no. Look what. Some food to deliver. Alrighty, I'm sorry, but I gotta leave y'all here. Let me just play this in the background.
But Ethan Gauthier is terminally sixth of the competition on the power play, gives Canada a 2-1 lead. Gord Miller back here with Craig Button in its fifth game of the tournament. 20 points.
Zone, getting down into the offensive zone to keep that offensive zone time and that pressure on their opponent. They do it everywhere. They do it with every.
This time I will leave it on.
In the neutral zone, and there's no hesitation whatsoever with their defense jumping up and getting into the play and making sure that if the Swedes are coming the other way, they close it down in the neutral zone as well and hold the blue line exceptionally well.
Teams start this second period 5-on-5. Canada holding a 2-1 lead. Ethan Gauthier, he was in the interview talking about how ticked he was. That first goal was waved off, so he helped the officials out with that goal signal. At the point, Sandin Pelika holds. He's down towards the goal mouth. That's swung away by Ratzlav. Benson chips that back for Jaeger. Zach Benson works in for Jaeger, in shoots, and the save is made by Erlinden on a streaking Braden Jaeger.
Pace, speed, attack. Well, here it is. It's not my words. You can watch it with your own eyes. How quickly they turn, and now they're skating. They're attacking. Jaeger gets it up, and then he fills that area. Now he gets it on the seam, and there's a scoring chance. Offensive zone faceoff, but that's how you attack. That's how you play with speed. That's how you play fast.
Richie wins the faceoff back to Molendijk. Back around for Kaelin Lind. Lind down to Richie. Callum Richie moves it back in the corner for Height. Height trying to work that back. He's taken down, and he in turn spills Tom Bielander as the Swedes come back the other way. Kelly Carlson plays it in. Hugo Pettersson, who has the Swedish goal, had that knocked away.
And Robbie Height high in the air to the Swedish blue line. That's gloved down by Wielander. That pass almost picked off by a forechecking Kalen Lind. Carlson tied up by Molendijk, and then Carlson falls as Lind skated through him. Bonk up to the Swedish blue line. Barlow reaching for it. Now Bonk has it back. Bonk played part of the year for the London Knights in the OHL. As Richie butts in alone. In comes Callum. Richie, little backhand shot. Great stop made there by Erlinden. Puck still loose. Erlinden dives back on it. But a great chance there for Canada's Callum Richie to make it a 3-1 game.
Tanner Molendijk does an excellent job of stepping up to stop this play. And now it goes the other way. Callum Richie trying to get Erlinden to open up somewhere along the line. He goes one way, goes back the other way, but gets in a little bit too tight, and he doesn't have any room to get it up and over the pad. Barlow comes back to it, can't fish it off that outside of the net, and then Erlinden jumps all over it to freeze play.
So Granin tries to move that out. In comes Barkey, and it's going to tag up as Howe is in ahead of the play, and back the other way comes Felix Nilsson. Rink wide, he goes for Sagrandin. And played back down to the Canadian zone as Tournier goes back for it. Jordan Tournier to Howe, chips it back down to the Swedish zone, and Christian Kostadinsky goes back for it. Icing called against Team Canada. This has been a meeting place for NHL executives this week. Toronto GM Kyle Dubas arrived late in the week after Jason Spezza was here. Rick Dudley, the Florida Panthers, is a scout without compare in terms of getting to games. He is a rink rat.
I'm watching Kyle Dubas there. He looks like he's setting up like Jason Spezza was set up.
Al Murray, the chief scout for Tampa, has been here all week, but there's been most of the NHL GMs have come through at some point, but more than 200 NHL people credentialed for this competition. Well, that shot deflected, and Ratzlaff had to be careful with that. Barkey has it stripped away by Forsskål. Howe trying to reach for it. Back across for Sandin Pelika. Shoots, it goes off the skate of Tournier over the glass and out of play.
And we talk about scouting a lot. We saw Jason Spezza earlier in the week, scouts, Kyle Dubas now, you know, trying to get the details. You're trying to get the details on these players, and there's a lot of details trying to find, and with respect to being able to scout and assess players. That's what you're trying to do. That's what the job is. So when you see the scouts and the managers taking notes and trying to make sure that they can understand and have points of discussion with their group about what players' potential is, all part of it.
If you go to a junior rink and you want to know where the scouts are, they're almost always in the corner.
Not me, ever.
Why?
Always at the red line. The game goes back and forth, not to you or away from you. Marshall Johnson, just a phenomenal scout, somebody I learned a lot from. He said, unless you're a goalie, that's the only time the play goes away from you and to you.
Stenberg tries to center. That's knocked away.
I was never a goalie. I sit right in the middle of the rink, back and forth.
There's a quick chance again for Forsskål. That's turned away and brought away by Wood. Matthew Wood falls in front of Lindstein, and now Lindstein plays it rink wide for Nord.
A lot of times the corners are the ones that are less populated, so that's why the scouts find seats over there.
You also don't have to move your head as much.
This is true.
Here's Wood.
My neck is okay. It can
in
move.
For a two-on-one. Crystal in, shoots, bouncing puck at the side of the goal. Wood trying to dig it free. A good stop there by Erlinden. Another good stop for the Swedish netminder to keep it a one-goal game. 3.5 gone here in the second period.
There's been some anxious times in front of that net, though, with some pucks bouncing around.
Crystal moves in again with Gauthier. Canada in the middle of a change. Pass dropped back to Tournier, who jumps in. Jordan Tournier played Memorial Cup this year as Crystal works it back in the corner. He's tied up there by Edvin Nilsson. Now picked free by Jaeger. Jaeger, fresh off the bench, picks out of the corner. Jaeger slides it back. Blindside a shot. Now another rebound. Crystal with a chance, and he looks skyward. Crystal had it teed up and just missed. Erlinden might have got a piece of that to knock it up and out.
Symmetry, synergy. Canada's working this puck in the corner. It's a real good play by Andrew Crystal. He keeps the puck alive, and then Braden Jaeger gets over there to help out. Then they find a way to free the puck, and now Weinstein comes right down after Jaeger gets the puck coming around. Working it really well together, Crystal.
That one off the stick of Edvin Nilsson.
Real good work, though, again. Like, working it in the corner, down low, and then the defense jumping in there to get a chance.
Here's Molendijk with it. Takes that pass from Jaeger, tries to poke it back. Jaeger holds the line. In comes Braden Jaeger. Shovels it back in front. Bouncing puck for Gauthier with a shot. Pad save by Erlinden. Another good chance for Canada. At the line, McKinnon steps up to keep it alive. And the long reach of Konstadinsky knocked that down, but Benson has it back. Zach Benson works free behind the goal. Slides it back in front. Benson. And McKinnon got knocked off the puck there. He thought he was interfered with.
He was.
And Landon has it back down to the Canadian zone as he lifts it over the head of Molendijk. That's icing called against the Swedes, who have tired players on the ice. And Canada will get a fresh line out there.
Ethan Gauthier with another glorious chance. But watch how he works with space. He stays a little bit out. And then when the puck moves into that area, he moves into it. And now you got a chance. You got net to work with. That's just brilliant offensive instincts. Because as the defenseman turns to try to find the puck, Gauthier knows where it is, jumps on it. Erlinden makes an excellent save.
Lynn wins the faceoff cleanly back to Price. Across he goes to Allen, shoots, and that was blocked by Pettersson. The lead pass for Pettersson broken up by Caden Price. One of four players in this Canadian roster who played minor hockey in Saskatoon. And now Lynn across the line was spilled there by Sandin Pelikka. The play was offside at the Swedish line. So where are these players from? Well, the bulk of them are from the Western Hockey League. 12 of the players on the roster are from there. 6 from the OHL, 4 from the Quebec Major Junior League, and 1 from the BC Junior League. That is Matthew Wood, who played for Victoria there. And we are in the home of the Red Deer Rebels of the Western Hockey League, who are among the teams you think will also be a contender for a Western Hockey League title next year?
Yeah, I mean, I think Winnipeg is the class of the East, but I think that Red Deer would be the next team there, and certainly there's lots of time for teams to make adjustments, but it's a good team here in Red Deer, Gord.
Lucas Segranin plays that back. Sandin Pelikka is tied up there by Height. Puck in the corner for Lucas Kling. Here's Bonk with it. Actually played part of the year for the London Knights, part of the year for St. Thomas. Which, depending on your point of view, is a Tier 2 Junior A or Junior B team, but for most of the country, it's known as Junior A hockey. Height plays it back in. Bouncing puck in front, score! Callum Ritchie gets a bounce and a goal to make it 3-1.
How many bounces has Callum Ritchie been able to take advantage of?
Well, he had the one yesterday in the semifinal game.
He had one in the first game where the puck went up and off the stick of the opponent against Switzerland. And now this puck is going around the glass and it kicks right back in front here. And Callum Ritchie, the puck comes down the wall and just around there, and then it just kicks right back. Erlinden has no idea where it is, and Callum Ritchie does, though. And Dave Reed was talking about Callum Ritchie and just his ability to just be very productive in a very quiet manner. There it is again, his 10th point of the tournament.
Got a point in every game. Second overall in the 2021 OHL draft. He had 19 goals this year as a rookie with Oshawa. As the man for whom this tournament is co-named, Wayne Gretzky, likes to say, at the end of the year, they don't ask how, they ask how many.
Well, he makes the play on the boards to create the turnover, and then he moves himself back into the scoring position. You know, that's how you take advantage of good fortune.
And here's Allen with it. So a two-goal lead for Canada for the first time in this game, and Barlow feeds it in. Allen plays it back around, trying to find Tanner Howe with that pass. Howe pulls throws a three. Back for Barkey. Barkey trying to find it. That's knocked away by Zeb Forsfjall. Forsfjall, who scored in the semifinal, drops that back. Stenberg can get a shot away. Now a chance for Barlow. Gets a step. In comes Barlow. He can fly. Barlow in a backhand shot. Erlinden the save. And another good stop by Swedish goaltender Noah Erlinden as Canada's Colby Barlow turns on the Jets and almost makes it a 4-1 game. You're watching the gold medal game from the 2022 Hlinka Gretzky Cup in Red Deer, Alberta.
Welcome to the Subway Eat Fresh, Refresh.
We got it. Cut.
Featuring the Great Canadian Club with turkey and pork raised on Canadian farms.
Give me some jazz hands.
No.
Okay.
Subway Eat Fresh, Refresh.
When pain says you can't, fight it two ways with new Advil Plus acetaminophen. Ibuprofen targets pain. Acetaminophen blocks pain signals. New Advil Plus acetaminophen fights pain for up to 8 hours.
If alcohol builds a wall around you, it doesn't let you see where you're going, it keeps you feeling isolated and alone. That makes you feel hopeless. Know this, we're here to help if you want us to. It's never too early or too late to ask for help with a drinking problem. Alcoholics Anonymous, there is a way out. For more information, visit AA.org and download the meeting guide app.
I'm not like those other hotels. I'm what you call boutique. I'm into intimate conversations, leather lounge chairs, and soaking up the city's atmosphere. I'm looking to provide a more unique experience. Do you like single origin coffee over a game of chess? Me too. And don't you just feel like everything sounds warmer on vinyl? I do.
Callum Ritchie, we talked about the bounce he got yesterday against Finland when the netminder Emil Vini kicked it in, and then tonight this.
Yeah, right off the backboard, just kicks right back. Erlinden's waiting for it to come out the other side, and Callum Ritchie says, it's over here.
Bad feeling for a goaltender.
Yeah, I mean,
not that he can.
It's a terrible break for Sweden. I mean,
yeah, and Sweden.
McKinnon knocks that down. Canada's had a wide edge in play here in the second period.
Time and time again, we've seen this from Canada, you know, finding a way to stretch their dominance, finding a way to keep their opponent not only back, but keep pushing them back and keep applying that pressure and creating opportunities. Stefan Julien has done a fantastic job with this group. It's a very talented group. But keep in mind, they've never played together.
So these players will be the core, likely, of Canada's World Junior team at the 2024 tournament in Sweden, in Gothenburg, Sweden. These are 2005-born players, so that tournament will see them likely be the top players on that team, normally 2 years after the tournament. Yeah. Most of them will also play the 2025 tournament, which will be held in Canada. That site's not yet determined. 2026 is the U.S. and 2026 back in Canada. This Christmas in Halifax, because it was supposed to be held in Novosibirsk and Omsk, Russia. But that World Junior and the subsequent World Championship for next spring were both stripped away from the Russians. And, of course, their teams are not participating. A long shot by Bergstrom, got through, and Ratzlaff makes the stop on that. A hooking call. And it goes against Colby Barlow.
This line throughout this tournament has been really good. Stenberg and Forsfjall,
right,
and Nord, and another chance in there. And you can see where Stenberg is looking to finish it, and then he gets hooked on the hands. No chance to get the ability to corral that puck. And now Sweden, I would suggest that this power play could be a very important one for Sweden to get back into this game.
Their power play is 5 for 15 in the tournament. Canada's penalty killing is 20 for 20 with 3 shorthanded goals. And right off the draw, we've got an interference call. And it's going against Sweden, so that power play ends 3 seconds in as Noel Nord goes off. It was right off the faceoff, and there it is. Nord takes down Denver Barkey.
Faceoff ready. You know, when the puck gets dropped, everybody has to be faceoff ready. Denver Barkey was faceoff ready. Noel Nord wasn't. That's how you draw a penalty. Just a play by being dialed into that certain situation creates an advantage and takes a big advantage away from Sweden. Very well done by Denver Barkey.
4-on-4 now for 1:57. Jaeger in for the faceoff, wins it back to Benson, but wasn't that fairly? The Swedes get the warning here. Jaeger's like, well, I won the draw. So they'll do it again. Hedstrom versus Jaeger. Benson all teed up for the shot. Jaeger wins it back. Benson pokes it to Jaeger. Looks behind the goal to Zach Benson. Benson slides that back for Tournier. Tries to throw that back in. And now knocked down by Benson to keep it alive for the moment. Jaeger back on it. Braden Jaeger. Again, Sweden can't clear it out. Here's Molendijk with it. Molendijk down to Benson. Plays it back to Molendijk. Across it goes to Tournier. Tournier shoots. That goes off the skate of Edstrom over the glass and out.
Canada's really good at freeing pucks up in traffic. We saw a scoring chance earlier this period by Weinstein. But even here, even though they don't have clear possession of a puck nor to sweep, they find a way to make sure that they can free it and then find a way to corral it after the fact without your opponent getting a hold of it.
Faceoff win this time by Lucas Kling of Sweden. And Bergstrom sends that rink wide. 4-on-4 here in the second period, a 3-1 lead for Canada. Barkey moves in. That's knocked away by Kling. Lucas Kling slides that back. Lead pass broken up from Richie, and Kling has it back. Stenberg across the top, feeds out across for Sandin Pelikka. And Axel Sandin Pelikka being watched there by Richie. Works it back and shovels that back for Vilander. Tom Vilander. Back for Sandin Pelikka. Deflected puck in front. Knocked away by Price. Richie has it back along with Barkey. End of a shift for these guys. And Richie sends it back down. The change begins for Canada. Stenberg with it. There'll be a 3-second power play for Canada at the end of this. As Allen looks ahead for Jaeger. Icing waved off as Vilander goes back. Skates away from Gauthier. Tom Vilander plays for the EIK Stockholm Junior Program. And now Gauthier with it. Ethan Gauthier. That pass broken up and brought ahead by Lindstein. Lindstein up ahead for Dauer Nilsson. And Molendijk closes on him. Tanner Molendijk. That power play for Canada is over after 3 seconds. And away comes Tournier. Jordan Tournier works in. Holds, trying to drop that for Gauthier. Now Ethan Gauthier has a roll away. Barkley on it. Denver Barkey. Loose along the boards, tries to knock down three. Now Howe with it. Howe. Still on it. Back down to Barkey. Barkey throws it back, and a shot by Tournier. The save made by Erlinden. 9:54 to go in the second period. Canada leads in the gold medal game by 2.
This is Sapporo, where influences blend, cultures connect, and Japanese artistry and Western tradition converge. You too can discover the remarkable where East meets West.
Are the color cartridges in your printer ready for another school year?
What's cyan mean?
It means cyan Mara honor roll.
The ink! Dad!
I'm so hosed.
Yeah, you are. the Epson Eco Tank Printer. No more cartridges. It comes with an incredible amount of ink that can save you a lot of trips to the store. Get ready for the Dean's List.
Who's Dean?
The Epson Eco Tank. Just fill and chill. Available at...
With Old Spice Sweat Defense Dry Spray, you get ridiculously long-lasting freshness that feels clean and goes on dry. With our patented technology, amazing Old Spice scent releases throughout your day. Old Spice Sweat Defense Dry Spray. Smell ready for anything.
Me and my buddies, we would get the Auto Trader and we'd scan through like it was comic books.
The app is so cool. You've got your listings. As you can see, is your nifty little great price badge.
Auto Trader has completely replaced my dad.
Hey.
It's great to see all our friends back at Montana's. It's Rib Fest, so come on and join us for our legendary all-you-can-eat ribs. Hickory smoked in-house daily, sauced and fire-grilled just for you. Montana's, the grill is calling.
Some of the famous names who played in this tournament, Sidney Crosby in the 03, what was then called the Junior World Cup, had four goals for Canada.
Taylor Hall. Already I am back. Hi guys, Shrek here. Shrek here from like that horror game, that Shrek horror game, Swamp Simulator Shrek, where his voice is not like Scottish at all, it's just very deep.
Yes, say so. NHL draft.
Alrighty, let's reorganize some shit here.
Montreal's first overall pick, and who it would be, Shane Wright or Juraj Slafkovský.
Hard shot by Allen, stopped there by Erlinden.
And you're going to have to make those decisions. They really like Juraj Slafkovský, but the minute they announced the trade for Kirby Doc, it all made total logic.
Right.
Like, you're going to take the big winger, get the big 21-year-old centerman, and away.
Here are some of the alumni for... Phoenix Cup at one time. Played in Japan.
Drew McGinley played in that, I believe.
Yeah. I think one year was held in Mexico, right? Was it one year?
It was Mexico City. If you thought the ice was bad here during a little bit of warm weather, I wasn't in Mexico City, but I know we had some of our scouts there, and they said it was hot, steamy, crowded.
Alrighty, back to my normal voice.
Playing ball hockey.
Crystal winds his way.
3-1, nice.
Thought about the lacrosse move there, spins it back in front, trying to find Rakoff.
Who scored? Canada.
Lucas Segrandin. Poke check to the line by Crystal. Now knocked back down to the Canadian zone. I think Wade Redden played in Japan.
Yeah, he was with Jerome on that team.
Picked up. Well, Rakoff works in and hammered down there by Axel Landon. Rakoff back to his feet. And Rakoff goes.
It was Richie. By Heidel.
At the point, Molendijk.
Assisted by Heidel already.
And I'll wrist it back in by Wood.
Right down. Let's let the watch.
Plays his hometown of Jönköping for the legendary HV71 program. A lot of these Swedish players play for three different teams of the year. U18, U20, and sometimes for the top level Swedish league club.
Most of these players aren't ready for that SHL level, top level Swedish club, but it gives
Alrighty.
Them a taste, you know, they're in the program, it gives them a
Rising Psycho,
taste.
If Strader is still streaming after this, remind me to rate him.
Terrific play there. Really good play with Kalen Lind and Riley Hike, but we talked about Carson Rakoff and the size that he possesses and the speed, but just a textbook body check.
Alrighty.
The big Rakoff breakdown. And then this is the play. The little.
Oh, it's the delivery. It was
Kalen Lind and Hike.
Pretty good. No.
The check from Landon and comes right back.
It was a Mickey D.
So here's the thing we talked
delivery
about.
And.
AIK and Jurgarden.
Sadly, I didn't see Rising Psycho there. I mean, not Rising Psycho, Recharge Noob. I didn't see Recharge Noob working. I was confused. But anyways, I ended up, yeah, so Raider. So yeah, other than that, the delivery location was pretty nearby, so what I meant, when I said, oh, I'll be right back, the right, in Psycho, It worked out.
That would have a trickle-down effect right down to the lowest levels of minor hockey.
Well, and as you talked about funding, right, and funding revenues come from different areas, TV and whatnot.
It worked out as in, like, it was literally going to just be, like, probably 5 minutes.
Collision in the corner with Landon again. Axel Landon's been throwing his weight around.
Alrighty.
Here's Allen back on it. Cameron Allen shoots. Erlinden makes the stop. And the rebound picked up by Benson. Zach Benson flips it back to Barkey. Skips back to Price.
Come on, Canada. Keep your lead here.
Sagan has blocked more shots in the last couple of games.
Yeah, well. Benson back. Yeah, but you're staying in a whole different city, Rising.
And a brought ahead by Jakob Sagan.
Oh, no. Oh, shit.
Here's Price with it now. Chance again for Canada.
And you occasionally visit them where I visit my family for the entire summer.
Once again, Howe digging for the rebound, but the Swedish netminder has it.
Canada is really, really going.
Alrighty, come on. Canada. Go, Canada, go.
Applying so much pressure on Sweden. Sweden's not able to really generate very much going the other way, and they've
Ooh, my last follower was like 25 days ago. That's how you tell I had a huge fucking break.
Canada looking to take even a greater grip on this game. And a fourth goal would certainly achieve that.
Well, did I upload yesterday? No, I didn't upload yesterday's stream. Rick. That's what I gotta do after this.
25 to 13 overall. Here's Tournier with it. Up for Howe. That's intercepted by Sandin Pelika. In comes Sandin Pelika. Drops it.
Oof.
Good stop there. Maybe.
Ooh.
Kangas rebound. Loose.
Ooh.
Another good stop. Maybe.
Nice. So far, Canada's goalie has only let in like one goal per game. Like, and like his usual is average. Is like zero goals. So.
Kraken of the NHL is from there. In fact, they're cousins.
So you can tell that we have a good goalie here.
In the world,
Scott Ratzlaff had only faced four shots to this point, and there's a quick play here.
If we go with stats, Team Canada's goalie is not supposed to let in another goal here.
Rebound. Good save.
It sure was on Sandin Pelika. Pelika just jumping right to the net area. There's mom and dad.
Saw their son lose a shutout with 18 seconds to go in the semifinal yesterday.
Yeah. Yes, indeed.
Banks it back down to the.
Yes, complimented his ass, and literally the instant he complimented his own ass,
Tom Vilander.
Half the viewers left. I guess they were weirded out.
Plays it up ahead. Stenberg centers it, knocked down by Price, and he banks it back out to center ice.
And it was pre recharge. Living in the house.
Away from Crystal. And now knocked back by Califor. Allen up to center ice. Crystal dropped that back for Califor. That's picked up now by Nord, but Allen knocked that away. Califor back on it. Flipped back in by Vilander. And Allen back to pick it up.
Should I edit the video for yesterday just so I can take out that like 20 minutes of like that 20 minutes of like be right back stuff, or do I just upload it as it is? Do I become lazy or do I don't become lazy and I actually edit it?
Still loose behind the goal. Here's Rakoff with it. Up ahead to Califor. And brought in by Crystal. Andrew Crystal. Waiting for help to arrive off the bench. Just holds that puck.
Damn. What a player. So, the fun fact about these players that all the players that are on this, in this tournament are players that are going to be drafted next year. The top pick isn't playing right now because next week there's another tournament, which is like the tournament that was supposed to be happening like at the beginning of this year, and then like got rescheduled to next week due to COVID. So he's going to be in that tournament. And I'll be doing some commentary on that. On that stuff. I meant edit as in just cut out the 20 minute of like be right back stuff, nothing fancy on the VODs channel. I feel like if I were to do a contest, the only people that were probably gonna edit would probably be you, and I don't know what the other person's username is, so I don't want to expose their name. But they would do it too, but they'd probably lose because of internet reasons.
Hi guys, Shrek here to announce an epic contest today. Will be whoever can help edit the video, Pelzer's video the best, could win $1 million. And with that, be featured on the Telsey channel. Yes, you heard me right. You could win $1 million.
What the heck is this one? Shit, Wi-Fi. No, so what happened?
What happened was that,
someone on a different team ended up getting COVID. I forgot which team got first, and then it just ended up spreading. So, and then in that world, the tournament's called the World Junior Tournament. And basically, what happened was a team got COVID, and then another team got COVID. And if your team got COVID, you were eliminated from the contest. So, because of that, too many teams were getting COVID, so they're like, fuck it, we'll just reschedule it. So yeah, so that's why they rescheduled it, and now it's going on next week.
Works it back across. The turn pass by Goche misfired, and back come the Swedes as Theo Lindstein has it. Rink wide pass for Forsfeld. Drops it back to Stenberg. Can't get a shot away. And Goche knocks Stenberg.
Exactly. But you don't want that to happen. He finds Barkey. Denver Barkey. Not like chicken pox. You can get COVID more than once. Or twice, I mean. Battle for the loose bucket. Barkey's right back on it.
And Barkey steps to the Sandin Pelica. What a great shift by Sandin Pelica, though.
So yeah, more summer hockey to happen next week. Literally, they have this tournament, and then next week, maybe another good tournament.
Came to play for the Vancouver Canucks. He was a point-a-game player for them. Of course, he played most of his great hockey in Europe. But what gets lost when you talk about his coaching prowess is what a great player he was. Canada Cup in 1976.
Alrighty.
Two-time Olympic medalist.
Yeah.
You know, you think about how fortunate we are that...
In 2 minutes, I'm going to go refill my water ball. I am empty on that. ...that we get to see on a regular basis. Right. There's Bergstrom teeing it up and shoots through the traffic that goes on. And there's my bed, my good night, my sleep water cup. That's also empty. Well, I would drink... I would get hydrated during them if it wasn't for the fact... If it wasn't for the fact that, like, I had, I had a job that was on call for. But,
Slava Fetisov, and he was, I mean, at one point in time, he was considered
Yeah, I could play the mini game again. That one pisses me off a lot, yeah.
You know, in his prime.
Crystal moves it back in for Richie. Look at that little move. Hello. Hello, Callum Richie.
How many deliveries will Telge get during this one hockey game? So far he's had two.
Those are quick hands.
One right at the beginning of the stream, and then a second one in the middle. Right as the second period was going to be in. The company was like,
Erlandin has to stay right with him. Yeah, he goes to water.
Oh, water. Okay.
Thought I could create a little bit better.
I thought you meant other things.
Shooting angle for himself, but Erlandin with an excellent save.
But yes, you go fill up my water ball during the intermission, and then we can play that hockey game.
And that goes off the stick of Allen. A shot taken by Sagrandin. We've also seen some attempts at the lacrosse-style goals today in both games.
All right, what happened?
Bronze medal game, and this one we saw.
Man tried attempting the Michigan. Rest in peace.
Crystal couldn't quite get it to go.
People are attempting the Michigan,
and earlier in the tournament,
which is like a which is a lacrosse move.
Off the pipe.
It's like basically using your hockey stick as a lacrosse stick and getting and scoring it.
Yesterday, bronze went to Finland. Their first medal in this tournament since 2012, which is hard to believe. But as you said, they use this as a.
Oh yeah. Like the Swedes, have a full after the hydration, we'll finish that hockey video we started last intermission, and then if there's any extra time, then we'll and then I'll play that hockey game.
The old Lindstein brings it ahead for Sweden.
And get pissed off.
But that plays offside at the game.
But yeah, tomorrow's stream is gonna be
Swedish team, like the Finns, Czechs, and others.
Fall Guys. We're gonna be playing some Fall Guys tomorrow. Today's stream was supposed to be a watch party stream. However, since we have this right now, it is. I decided. You know what?
And of course, the men's national teams also play.
Let's do the hockey stream today.
Players, because of the same coaches, they're testing the players. They get a comfort level for how players respond to different situations. Canada will go to the U18 tournament, and they don't know who the coach is because it's all dependent on who's available. Stefan Julien has a good team in Sherbrooke.
Oh yeah, I should maybe charge my phone. Bro, where's my charger? Alrighty, that's another thing to do in the intermission is go find my phone. My phone charger, I mean. Just so while I'm in the middle of doing delivery, it's like, nope, sorry, no battery for you. I mean, it's at 20%, but still. Alrighty, that is the end for that period. So, what happened in this period? Whoa. You gotta get that. The Shrek voice.
Yo. So, what happened? During the second period, ball is gone. What? Ball didn't refresh. Oh wait, never mind, it's just the one goal. For whatever reason, I thought... Wait a second. No advertisement here. Whoa. Zero advertisements. Get the shit out of here, bro. Get the shit out of here. Oh fuck, what did I do? I didn't do anything, Jim. Alrighty. I might have to split this off into two just so we can also see the other stuff that's going on. Alrighty. I'll leave it this screen. But we'll get the viewer back. No, not that one. Put the viewer back thing just to go grab our stuff.
SpongeBob, this flapping robot Krasis is making the Krusty Krab.
What the fuck?
Like
the
fuck is... means no more Krusty Krab. No more Krusty Krab. No more fried
What is this voice?
So now I can do PS4 streams again. I mean, somewhat of a downgrade from the PS5 stream, but whatever. Bruh. Oh shit, that was clutch. 43 out of 42, what the fuck? It's happening! It's happening!
Taken down behind the net!
Yes!
Yes!
Yes! Shit, I made it! I was being so cocky there, and I made it. Let's go, baby! First! Let's go! Let's go! Yeah, we're playing football, guys. Oh my god. Oh my god, I crossed the field! I crossed the field! Goals! My god. As I'm talking about Christian Tvorak, he scores. What the heck? Yes! Woo! 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 Yeah! Go! Let's go! Let's go! Under the sea! Don't touch me! Go! 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 Tap on the mic! I'm gonna die!
The fact you're alive is astonishing.
Go, 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 tap out the back fuzzy! I'm gonna die! Holy sh**! The thing is right there! Oh my f**ing god! Are you here? God. Yes! Yes! What? What? Bullshit! Fucking bullshit! That is so bullshit. The fucking thing glitched and it fucking... That is fucking... Oh, you son of a bitch! Oh, you son of a bitch! Oh no! Oh no! Oh boy, that was the washrooms of death. Get me out of here. Holy shit, how did I manage to strike that? Ted is the man, so he'll for sure come back. I have no doubts about it. Ted's gonna go up to them and be like,
they're gonna be like, give me the food. I want all the food right now, and give me all everything that you have, including the weapons. I want a new map, I need an axe, and everything in the medkit. That's all I want, that's all I ever wanted.
Yep, that's what I want to do.
Who'd you rate it?
Very. This is my rating.
Yeah.
Yes, that was very cold. I'm gonna give it a 6 out of 10. The missing 4 is because it's not that sweet. Like it's lemonade. Come on.
What the fuck?
I need a hero. Fuck off, you cunt. Go! Let me in! Wi-Fi! Wi-Fi! Go! Let me in! Let me in, Wi-Fi! I swear to fucking God.
How was that? Next up is this.
What is this? No way! No. They didn't fuck it up. They didn't mess it up. They did not mess up the memes. They did not mess up the memes. I'm done.
Or I could have been mistaken. Oh, I'm just... Holy shit! Get out! Oh shit, we're going down!
Go, Dave! This is content!
Content! Fly into...
How you boys feeling? Feeling like death yet?
Okay, 10 seconds in.
Well, I'm dead in the inside, so it doesn't really matter. Oh my God,
what the hell?
Oh!
Jeremy, psycho!
Oh, he's drinking!
Jeremy, psycho, isn't he, Nathan?
Oh, those kids, ruthless. Absolute savages, man.
Crazy, isn't it?
Crazy, there's a kick.
Yeah.
You know what?
NANI!
Oh, give me another shot.
No way!
Holy fuck, these are unbindle. Alrighty, and it is Nom. I get fucked. Alrighty, I've done some more investigation for you. Looks like the ghost's name is David. It's David. David's the ghost. Oh, that's a room. It's Santa Man. It's Santa Man. It's actually Santa. What the fuck? Get your ass in the van. Okay, so now it's a...
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll just push mine over to the side a little bit.
Where are the fries? Like the smelly face fries.
Uh-oh. Oh, they are.
Quick!
FBI! Open it up! Did you use all of them?
No.
No, okay.
Here. Well, they're probably in here still.
Oh. The heck, there you go. I think there's another one.
Oh, thank you, Ellis. We're almost there.
There's a safe room up ahead.
Come on, get your asses in here, Ellis.
Get your asses in here.
Sorry, I can't go any faster.
Fucking go! How about that?
A banana? The banana? Eh? Eh? The banana? The banana? Banana! 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 Banana. Banana. Alright. I am the back from the delivery. I'm fast as fuck, boy. I'm fast as fuck.
I am back from the delivery. I am back from the delivery. As I am back, and Canada will be playing against Latvia on Wednesday. I just knocked my phone. I am back, and my phone cord was over my self. Already, are they gonna be flying or what? Hello? Hello?
Away from Jaeger at a close chance there.
Now, look,
How about the 1978 World Junior Tournament? He's a replacement. He's 16 years old, and Ernie McLean is coaching.
Alrighty, enough of that. Time to watch the hockey.
And you know, Ernie's getting all these calls. You got to have Greg. Oh, okay, we'll take the little kid there. The little kid led the tournament in scoring.
He showed up in Montreal. His roommate was Steve Tambellini. Gretzky walks into Tambellini and said, "This is the guy that's been ripping up the Ontario Hockey League."
Yeah. I was there on Christmas Day, Gord. So, you know, my father was running NHL at the time. And
one last period. Hopefully. Czechoslovakia, the former Czechoslovakia. Actually, I don't care if the delivery and like picked over it or not, because I'll be making the money. The money. We went to the outdoor rink and I'll be making the money. Alrighty.
It was just, you'd heard about him. It was pretty impressive.
He woke up that morning away from home for the first time at Christmas, called his dad and said, "This is
alrighty, come on."
Walter said, "Don't worry, it's going to get better."
Come on, it's like Canada, and let's do this. Do this. Scores the goal. You just scored the goal.
There's a decent chance that a dozen players who will go in the first round of next year's draft are playing in this.
Oh, there's no question about it. Just no question.
Theo Lindstein moves out ahead for Lucas Kling, busting in. Kling throws it back in front. That's knocked away by Barkey.
Well, I just ran into Matthias Johansson.
Oh, yeah.
Played in Färjestad for Lande. He was a Calgary Flames draft pick. He came over when I had become the general manager. We brought him over as...
How much of the money have you earned today? I think like 30 bucks.
I run into it. His son is number 27, Willie Johansson.
Is that right?
Yeah.
I said, you know, with all the Johansson...
And everyone's been giving like a dollar or two tips, so... Ching.
Really nice to see him. He was a really smart, you know, what you would call a third line, you know, down in the lineup type player. But boy, was he smart and could play the game and a real good, strong defensive player.
Stenberg plays that back. The pass across for Edvin Nilsson. Moved ahead for Crystal. It rolls down to the Swedish goal. And Erlin hangs on to that. And it's worth underlining two things. Number one, how good borderline NHL players are.
Yep.
Like how great they are. Like better than anyone you've ever played with, or for the most part. And the second part is when you take, you know, we talk about the 2005 Canadian junior team, the best junior team we've ever seen. Six players in that team really didn't have much of an NHL career.
What do you mean, what? I've only done like six deliveries.
Two defensemen, two forwards were not big-time players in the NHL. I mean,
oh, that.
Point for them. And that's the best junior team we've ever seen.
Just ignore that for now.
Sweden got called twice for this yesterday. Plus, they got called for playing the puck illegally by the goaltender. They had three delay of game penalties in that semifinal win against Czechia. So here they get delay of game as Edvin Nilsson goes off. But Rajan Boschman, Jeff Glass, Sean Bell.
On and on and on, yeah. I put my hands up in the air sometimes, saying, hey, baby, let's go.
You're just saying, like, that's the very best players in their age group. Now, six other guys in that team played the Olympics 5 years later. Crosby, Bergeron.
There's a few of them headed to the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
That's a pretty good group. Cameron Allen on the Canadian power play.
I just clapped like I was a schoolgirl. Yeah, the devil's haunting me again.
A very different type of team. I mean, as good a job as he did with that group in Grand Forks, I think he did as equally great a job in Vancouver, leading Canada to the goal. A very different group.
Zach Benson slides it back. Allen, a hard shot, save made by Rutherford.
Allen.
Now Benson back on it to Allen.
Oh, Allen. I was like, what? And held the line by Allen. Benson takes that pass, feeds it back in front of his tap. Come on! Fuck. The goalie's lost. Oh, yeah. It's like a yard. Come on! The pass goes off the goal stick to height. Was he tap on that? Got a forward with it. Clint, the forward has no glove on his left hand. He's putting it behind his back when Canada looks to shoot.
Calafort with it. Benson works back in, drops that back to Allen. Now a hard jump by Height goes wide. Gauthier back with it. 10 seconds to go on the power play. Height flips it back.
Go! Oh! And with one tabarnak
gloved, Lucas Kling sends it down. That's going to be a very nervous feeling to be out killing a penalty with one glove on. One shot for Cannon on that power play remains a 3-1 game.
The Swedish goalie literally had only one glove on and missing his stick as well. What a guy.
They were not on the ice for an even straight goal against in the tournament.
So impressive. I mean, Justin Pogge was brilliant in the net for Team Canada.
In comes Barkey, shovels that across. And Barlow plays it back in.
McKinnon back. Come on. Was he?
And McKinnon shoots that deflected through and Erlander makes the stop.
Yeah, there is a freaking knife throwing competition going on TSN 2, I think. Today, when I was setting up. Watch that, and my god, that was interesting. I didn't know knife throwing was an actual, like, sport. Or, like, people did that competitively.
The first time this tournament was held there. Kaelin Lind works in. And Lind was dumped. McKinnon long shot.
Oh my god. The hell's going on over there? Why is there no penalty? Match ensues in behind the Swedish goal. And an enraged Tom. The fucking Canada player is just getting fucking body slammed by the fucking Swedish player. Well, what the hell is going on there? Amen, amen, amen. Ding, 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 ding! Amen. Hallelujah. Alrighty. Who wants to go to church today? Amen, amen, amen. Alrighty, let's read off these donations. Hi, Telje. It's me. It's me, Kissiam. I'm from... Oh, no. Never mind. That's an old one. Alrighty, let's read the next one. It's coming from a Santa man. Ooh, Santa man. Okay, Santa man, what do you want? Hi, this is Santa man. Today, I learned a lesson when it came to being a filmmaker. Never leave the lens cap on. It is a bad idea. Whoa! Amen! 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 Thank you for the subscription. Amen! 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 Alrighty, let's continue this up.
The figure four. I don't know what all the wrestling moves are, but that's the figure four. Then we know it. But here's
already back to reacting to hockey.
Kling loses his glove.
No, we're keeping the hat on.
Some chances, pretty good opportunity.
Amen, amen.
Just can't make contact with that quick pass just off the heel.
Sweden is 0 for 1 on the power play of the game. Their first one was 3 seconds long. They took a penalty right off the draw.
Thank you, Rising Psycho, for the subscription. subscription for 10 years. God damn. It's longer than I've known him.
And a stop by Ratzlaff, so a key moment here in the game for Sweden.
And Ratzlaff knows who the key trigger man is here. So off the face-off, you know, Ratzlaff is tracking, okay, trying to size up where everybody is.
Oh yeah, let me fix this graphic here so you can actually see if Canada scores here.
Composed goaltending by Scott Ratzlaff.
Went unbeaten in his first 17 games in regulation for Seattle last year. He went all the way to the conference final, or to the league final, rather. Ratzlaff leaves it there. Battle back around the boards and down the ice.
Seattle had two first-round draft picks. Number 7, Kevin Korchinski to Chicago, and at 32, Reed Schaefer to the Edmonton Oilers.
And let's put this one up.
Benson goes after it. Canada does have 3 shorthanded goals in the tournament.
Voila, perfecto.
And here is Stenberg with it. Lead pass for Edstrom. David Edstrom. Being watched by Benson, then McKinnon bumps him. Loose in the corner. Jaeger with it. Braden Jaeger, such a big part of Canada's attack on the power play, even
voila,
killing penalties.
Perfecto.
He really is a complete two-way centerman.
35 seconds to go on the Swedish power play. Barkey picks it up. And Denver Barkey being harassed there by Edstrom. Slid back ahead and brought up by Barlow, who has 2 short hands.
No, this hat is actually my grandpa's hat. I didn't buy this hat.
Once again, Colby Barlow is lethal shorthanded for Canada.
I mean, he's a big, powerful player, but he's got skills to boot. I mean, his skills.
My grandpa had one each of these. I like had a hat for all of his grandkids, basically, when he died. That's the amount of hats that he had of this type whenever, when he died, which was like coincidental.
Could have been another short-handed goal for Colby Barlow.
Basically bought these types of hat whenever he went vacationing.
Face off,
yeah.
Back, but it's picked up quickly and moved across by Felix Nilsson. Pops that back, and that shot taken by Lucas Segrandin. Ramps off the stick, so sometimes you sit on the bench, not the sweep.
It's like people who don't know smiley face. People who don't do know.
And,
oh God,
you know,
face.
At the U18 tournament in April in Germany, they ended up winning the gold medal there. So maybe it's their new superstition: we stand, we win.
Well, when you're 17, you can do that.
Yes, this is true.
That long shot got through. Rebound, Ratzlaff, a great stop there.
All righty, come on. Don't let in more than one goal here. Statistically, it's either one goal against Canada or 0 goals against Canada.
What a save that was.
GG, nice save.
Here is Lynn with it now. Lynn goes rink wide to Rakoff. Gains center ice and fires that down, and Canada needs its penalty killers off the ice. But what a chance that was for Lucas Kling, and turned away by Scott Ratzlaff. Played back in by Willie Johansson. Here's Jordan Tournier. Lead pass at center ice is knocked down by Lindstein. Up ahead to Sagan.
Oof. That was a nice hit there.
Canada's defense again. They have played forward everywhere on the ice. Applied pressure. They said, this is how we're going to play, and all the defensemen have embodied it.
Brought ahead by Jaeger along with Benson. Zach Benson and roll off his stick. Jaeger back on it. And that's picked off by Dower Nilsson. Drops it back for Wielander. And Tom Wielander, the defenseman, chips it in. Back goes Tournier, reverses that for Molendijk. Molendijk snaps that pass rink wide for Gauthier. It skipped under his stick. And Bergstrom goes back for Sweden. Up ahead for Forsfeld. Here's Price with it. Banks it across the crystal.
Okay, Vasim is a me. Go, go, go.
And Andrew Crystal, plays for Cologne in the Western Hockey League.
Wow, Andrew, you're playing hockey? What?
Now brought ahead by Forsskål. Lost the puck to Rakoff. The poke check there by Sandy Pelican, who jumped up. Now back at the point. Long shot taken there by Bergstrom. Kicked out again by Raslav. Scott Raslav has been tested here on the Swedish power play and beyond. Now, coming here to Canada.
Fuck.
9:54 to go.
Amen, amen, amen. Can I get a hallelujah in the chat? Hello? No? Okay. Alrighty. Today we got the reaction. We're gonna pray for our fellow Team Canada to win the tournament here. They're close. Literally one game close. They're winning 3-1. It's gonna be a good one. So because of that, Amen, Rising Psycho. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God have mercy on Team Canada. Amen, amen, amen. Hey, whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, Rising Psycho. Whoa. We do not speak like that in the chat. Rising Psycho. What did I tell you about spilling some secrets? SMH, especially in this church. The Telge Tabernacle. Tailgate Church, the TTC. Yes, that's right, the TTC. The Telge Tabernacle Church, TTC. Which has nothing. Alrighty. Church is over for now. Back to the hockey game.
Oh. Past the midway point of the third period.
God have mercy, I'm about to bust.
Stenberg and
because Canada's doing great.
I mean, it's just such fundamentally sound goaltending. Andrew Crystal, a little tap on the glass for his goaltender.
Off the glass. That was...
Alrighty, come on.
By Caden Price and banked it out. Brought it now.
Enough of that propaganda, Ring. Thank you.
Back to Stenberg, who's behind the Canadian goal. Forsskål. Back to Sandin Pelican. Forsskål, rink wide for Stenberg, who was tied up there by Barlow. Sandin Pelican walks back in and shoots at the deflected by
Chico. Oh!
That might have hit Caleb Lynn. He's limping.
I heard somebody say, holy fuck. Bro.
Edstrom tried to wrap it back around, and Caleb Lynn is laboring noticeably for Canada.
Alright, 9 more minutes to go. And so far, we haven't been distracted by a delivery.
He'll play it down that'll allow Caleb Lynn to limp off the ice after blocking
that shot. My man blocked a shot and he's gone.
He gets it directed out of harm's way.
Ooh.
Pucks laying around, kicking him back into the slot.
Boom, ba-dum, boom, ba-dum, boom. Bum 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 bum.
You know, getting it, there it is right there to the corner. Some goaltenders are so focused in on the save now it kicks out.
Alrighty, come on.
That makes a terrific play on that shot.
Stop Sweden from spreading their false propaganda. Stop the Swedes from the false propaganda this year.
Drops that back, and now Dower Nilsson of the hustle pack is Denver Barkey. As they say, eyes like a butcher's dog, seeing that puck sitting there.
Oh! Whoa! Whoa! Excusez-moi! Do not trip my boy.
Another penalty drawn by Denver Barkey with his quickness and his aggressiveness. And
Tom Vilander goes off.
Hounding the puck. On the penalty kill, there's Denver Barkey. He's invested.
Whoa.
Right invested in the fight.
SMH.
And ends up drawing the penalty because of his tenacity and determination.
Alrighty. Canada.
So Canada will get a power play in 19 seconds. They had a 3-second power play earlier. Both teams have had a 3-second power play.
Canada. This. Canada. This is where you score. Come on. 4-4. Then power play for us. This is where you take advantage and get the 4-1 lead. Amen.
Richie in shoots and the save is made.
Ooh, so cool.
5 seconds to go in the Canadian penalty and then a power play for a minute and 41.
That's Hlinka for Team Sweden. Two tripping at 11:47.
Two opportunities on the power play for Sweden. There's no way they can go down 4-1 and expect to be on the
Rising is
no way.
Straighter.
To this point in time in the tournament.
It's straighter.
Left in fifth
still
game,
surrendered
3 goals.
Yeah.
Streaming.
No more than one in any game.
We know how good the offense is on this team and how well they
stand.
Defensive effort and approach.
What? Wanna walk in while all night.
To their success here.
And party every day. Wanna rock and roll on that.
Very brief one.
Alrighty, 8 more minutes now.
Molendijk with the center ice and winds it into the Canadian man advantage. Molendijk.
Yes, perfect though. If he's still streaming in like 15 minutes.
Back in front by Richie, but that just wide.
And voila.
Back at the point held by Molendijk.
Me rating him. It's movie night for him. Damn, I should join him. My previous movie watcher partner failed me, so I guess I'll do that one. I guess I'll have a new one.
Slides that back to Tournier. Back for Jaeger. Jaeger shoots at the And now it's hacked down the ice by Christian Kostadinsky. Kostadinsky's gonna be interesting. He's a great big guy, 6'5", 214. He's obviously awkward at that age, but someone will take a chance on him.
Well, yeah, they will, and decisions don't have to be made here in August. You get to watch him over how much more he improves over the course of the season.
See? Me and Schrader, we
take longer, as you know.
What is it? We
you know,
read each other's mind. We talk sight. We talk through mind reading or whatever. We talk on a psychological level. We're connected that way.
Joche plays out ahead. Inside 6 to go in the third period. We will stay at the conclusion of the game for the player of the game presentations of the silver.
Rising Cycle, I'll explain later.
Along with the championship trophy.
Let me just say I didn't make the effort this time.
Makes the stop on that and is able to hang on. 3-1 Canada leads in the third period.
Alrighty, back to church. Amen. Canada has killed off the power play, Sweden's power play. And now they have their own power play. Let's go. Alrighty, so. So, Rising Psycho. Telekinesis, yes. That's what I was thinking about. Sure.
LG Tabernacle Church. It is time for Telji's Church. Oh no. Well. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Right, recharge noob, subscribe for the 10th year in a row. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, recharge noob. What a legend. 10 years in a row, that's more than I've known him. Oh my god. Holy shit. Recharge. Are you sure? My god. My man's been doing big plays here.
It is time for hockey. And it's time for hockey. And it is time for hockey. Hallelujah. We will Canada win against Sweden. Will Canada win against Sweden? Will Canada win against Sweden? If they lose, it will be disastrous. Canada will go insane. The demons will take over.
Junior tournament.
In Ostrava and Czechia.
All right.
Trying for a push here.
Sweden, do not try for the push. No, you're done. You're done, mate. You're done.
We talked about giving up three goals. They haven't been behind in a game, Canada, that is, the entire tournament.
Rising Psycho, how would you rate my singing?
And Barkey knocked his man, Forsfell off the puck.
No, my laptop! I can't monitor the chat now.
Second try through the middle for Barlow, chips out ahead. And Tanner Howell plays it back down. From the wrong side of center, icing call. They'll have to come back on the ice for a faceoff in the Canadian zone. And it's a long road from early mornings in minor hockey to get to the upper levels. There's Scott
Rowland,
Diana Gord.
How was my singing, reach, Rising Psycho? How was my auto tune? Man, you like when you say thanks. The auto tune didn't even catch up.
And he won a gold medal with Canada at the World Junior Championship.
Ouch. My heart has been broken.
The change. With 4.5 to go in the third period. Bouncing puck. Scooped ahead to Gauthier. In comes Gauthier. Poke up his check there by Tom Bielander. Ratzlaff out the point. Pokes it there to McKinnon. Chops it ahead to.
Alrighty. 420 left.
Icing waved off. As Theo Lindstein goes back.
Oh! And a boo! Macarena! Moment, that is the night, and the red route, ceiling can hold us. Ceiling can hold us.
Zachary Benson goes back, and now the
players. Yay, Macarena. La Macarena. Woo! 4-1. Haha. Good. Haha, Sweden. Amen. Hallelujah. Brandon Jaeger, assisted by Benson.
Time when Canadians are looking for something to feel good about with hockey, this team this week has given them that. There are lots of issues to be addressed and lots of time to do that, but on the ice, this has been a dominant performance from start to finish.
15. Bon français.
The issues that plague it presently need to be addressed. They need to be cleaned up.
Go. So. Hey. Goal! 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 Goal!
Back ahead for Gauthier. And McKinnon goes rink wide, trying to find Benson with it. Scooped up behind the net by Edstrom. Looks there for Callie Carlson. Now back at the point, that long shot goes off Molendijk in front. Taken there by Axel Landon.
Now moderating the stream with my own.
Long shot taken there by Pettersson, and Bratislav wasn't sure where it was, but he's got it.
Pettersson, the goal scorer for Sweden in this game that tied it in the first period. But he was a really good offensive defenseman.
Alrighty. Two more minutes and 20 seconds to go.
Oh, look out, that's over the glass and by Lind. That'll be a penalty to Kaelin Lind.
Well, we got power play for the rest of the game except for the last 19. That puck going over the glass.
Yeah, there it is. Just ends up. Oh, Kaelin, no.
Sorry, healthy.
Oh, no. I can't believe I do that.
So the Swedes will call timeout here. 2:19 to go. And
oh, he's crying. He didn't get hit.
Our dear friend, Mr. McLean, who wrote the song Puck Over Glass.
Yes.
Still number one on the TSN hockey music charts. Should be queued up every rest time somebody peace. Puts it over there. Maybe Kaelin Lind, the reason he has his hands over his face is because he can.
Well, he's disappointed. Not crying.
Song in his head.
Well, better to do it at 4-1 than 2-1. It was a famous puck over the glass penalty, the 2008 World Championship.
Hey, Sweden has a penalty. Power play, I mean, for the rest of the game, except for the 19 seconds.
I remember 06 when Brian Campbell in the West in the Eastern Conference final against the Carolina Hurricanes. Yeah. And remember, you know, the new
basically, there'll be 19 seconds in the game when Sweden is done with this power play. Oh, fuck. And an empty net for Sweden. Shit. They're really pushing for it, aren't they? Just fucking keep on keeping it in the corner. Get her done, boys.
Is for Lynn as he'll get out in time to join the celebration should it happen, and it's looking very likely at this point. Sandine Pelican,
come on Canada. The ball. Just heard an F bomb. Boom. Woo! Holy shit.
I mean, all we did was hear it. Heard it. But what a release. Andre Fleury and influence.
Not even a shot, they say. Not even a shot on goal.
Oh, shit. I'm missing the last minute of the game. No! Fuck! Fuck! Bastards! You bastards!
A shot there by Felix Nilsson turned away. Empty net. Molendijk plays it back to center ice. Gathered up by Barlow. Backhanded towards the goal. And that's blocked by Tom Wilander.
Canada won a gold medal in this ring. My Wi-Fi's about to cut out.
That pass is knocked away. That was the old round robin format. They actually won it in the dressing room watching Sweden play Finland down in Calgary. That's poked in by Molendijk.
Shit.
And Gauthier puts that wide.
Well, I'm just gonna celebrate it like it is right now. Good job, Canada! Good job. GG. Well, I'm not staying for the thing, but...
Not surrendering a power play goal in this tournament. Only surrendering three to this point with 19 seconds left.
So Lynn steps back on. That's hammered high. By Forsvall, he'll hang on. Da, 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 da.
Thank you for watching the stream. Wi-Fi. We won. Hey, my LMAO. Canada won. Let's go. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you later. Thank you for watching, baby. We won, we won, we won. Bye, bye, bye. Thank you for watching. See you later, baby. Alrighty. Thank you for watching. Bye, bye, bye. Bye.